The brand new Crush Station is an overdrive distortion plugin by Eventide Audio. In this review, I will show you how you get from this to this by only using the Eventide Crush Station. I'm Marlon and this is the White Noise Studio. The Crush Station is a brand new overdrive distortion plugin for desktop and iOS. The Crush Station itself has been around for a few years as a module for the H9 pedals. When this plugin was first announced, I was like, okay, another distortion plugin. I used the SP2016 reverb and I like that one a lot, so I downloaded the demo. The best way to get to know a plugin is by using it. So I uploaded my trusty Rock Dub Loop and started to play around, and I went from this to this. When I do a plugin review, I want to do a review of a plugin which has unique features. And I found out that the Crush Station has these unique qualities. You will find out in this video. If you look at the plugin, you will see it's laid out pretty clear. You have input and output volume sliders, a mix control and a bunch of controls to adjust the distortion. Let's go over the Crush Station one track at a time. Here's the kick drum and here's the Crush Station on it. B is no processing in this case, and A is what it has become. Let's go over the controls. Let's start off with drive. Then we have sustain, which can be set to pre-distortion or post-distortion. So it will increase the sustain before the distortion or after the distortion, which will sound different. And then we have sag, which sounds like a broken tube. Let's dial that in. Besides that it sounds like a broken tube, it also shortens the decay, so you can use it as a sort of a gate. Here we have the octaves control, which will dial in an octave above and an octave below the signal. And there's grit. Grit will add a low end before the drive. Which will make the sound grittier. They've included a gate, which is a simple gate with a threshold, which is nice, slow and fast attack. And then we have the EQ controls, bass, mids and treble. Of the mids, you can select the frequency. And I created the following sound for this track. I just press the A button. So this adds a little bit of drive and is not completely mixed in. And then we have snare drum. And without Crush Station, I went again for more grit and punch and drive for this snare drum. It's mixed in 50% and it has added in the gate. With the gate, you of course gate the track, and if you blend that in by 50% or something, you keep the original bleed nicely intact, which will only process, in this case, the attacks of the snare. Let's continue with skank. It sounds like this without Crush Station. And with Crush Station. With this, I went 100% with Crush Station and wanted to create a real lo-fi guitar sound. Next up are the delays of the skank, and it sounds like this without Crush Station. And this is how it sounds with Crush Station. With this, I really used the octaves button to create a more synthesizer or a pad sound. And we have an electronic hi-hat, and it sounds like this clean. And with Crush Station. So again, I went for a low-fi hi-hat sound instead of a very sharp, high-pitched hi-hat. And here we find a reverb, and there's a reverb of the snare. First, I will play it clean, of course. Okay, and this is with Crush Station. And here I just wanted a really loud, saturated, distorted sound. And there's also a bass, and with bass there's something special happening. First I will play it clean, and then with crustacean, and then I will say what is happening with it. First clean. And now with crustacean. Here's one of the unique features of crustacean. It's this bar in the middle. With this bar, you can fade between two completely different settings of crustacean. With the iOS version, you can of course play with it while sweeping over the screen. And in a DAW, you can automate it. That is what I did. Check it out. Here's the automation curve of that bar. And I've set the sound in such a way that it sounds like an envelope filter. Okay, let's play the track in total. Okay, let's play it once again without the plugins. The Eventide Crustacean. I thought it was just a distortion plugin, but it is much more. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. If you want to see more plugin reviews, check them out here. I'll see you next time. Bye!